everybody. It's Dave and Deb of theplanetd.com.
And today we're going to take you on a tour of our favorite European city, Dublin, Ireland. Your first stop when you visit Dublin should definitely be the Little Museum of Dublin. What I loved about this museum is that it has an eclectic mix of historic things that have been crowdsourced. So everything from their U2 collection to the first Irish independent office and everything in between. So you really get a great feel for what it was like back here in the 20th century in Dublin.
No trip to Dublin would be complete without going to the Guinness Storehouse. Make sure you do a tour to learn all about the history and drink a pint or two.
It's a room of magic.
Hello, thank you so much.
Give us a little Guinness River Liffey.
Oh yeah, that's good.
So we're all geared up and ready to go here on the Etihad Skyline Walk. Let's go! So we did the Skyline Walk here at Croke Park and we're like 44 meters off the ground. It's a really great bird's eye view of this stadium.
When you come to Dublin, make sure that you visit the Book of Kells. It's an extraordinary book, 1,200 years old, and it's so rare to see something so vivid from that time. It's the four Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Now, there's no photography or video in the Book of Kells itself, but we are in the Long Hall, and this is an extraordinary, extraordinary room filled with 250,000 books. Wow. When you're in Dublin, jump on a lazy bike tour to see the city. These fully guided tours take you to all the historic sites as you ride easy on electric bicycles.
So we're heading into Swaney's to learn a little bit about James Joyce and this amazing chemist. Let's go.
Literary fans will love this shop as owner PJ shares colorful Dublin stories and hosts daily readings from your favorite James Joyce novel. So we hope you enjoyed our city tour through Dublin.
And we hope you include it on your next trip to Europe. It's an amazing city.